Hi, my name is Asma Sheikh. I'm 36 years old and I work at my family business in Kilburn at a hijab shop. When I did have my tie slashed and then on the screen saying go back home, which is something that frightens you. So that frightened me a lot at that time, but it didn't frighten me enough to move the person that I am. But at that time I didn't report my tyres being slashed, and I didn't report what was written on the windscreen, simply because I was wondering, while I was thinking, I'm in this neighbourhood, if I go and get this situation reported, the police are going to come down, they're going to investigate the area, everyone's going to know it was me. Things will get worse and I can't handle that. That's the only reason I didn't report it. That was fear, and you know what, if I could go back in time, I wish I had reported it and faced the consequences. Well, I decided maybe 1 year ago to look into how I could put my feelings into words. I know I can talk very well, but I wanted to talk in a way where I could make an impact. So I was actually approached by a woman, and she said, we're doing a ladies' leadership course. And I said, you know what, I'll just give it a go. As days went by, I enjoyed it so much because women from all corners of the world were coming, teaching us how to speak and how to express our feelings, starting from here, coming out from here. And I think that gave me such a big boost. And I think I didn't stop from there. For me, my kids are my drive. So I see my kids and I say, I don't want my kids to be afraid of who they are. I don't want them to be in shame, having their head down saying, oh goodness me, I'm a Muslim, I better hide and walk away. No, if I don't make a stand, they won't. So I would encourage other brothers and particularly sisters who have been victim to many, many hate crimes. Yes, it's never gonna be easy. It's never ever gonna be easy for us. But next time you have gone through a hate crime in some way, just think about your loved ones. Think about your children, think about your elderly, think about your siblings, think about them. Saying it is a big deal. Saying what you feel is a big deal. Being heard sometimes can mean the world. And I did many events where I was able to stand up and speak out and say something where I was understood. I mean, I've got people stopping me in local shops, local areas, saying, sister, you know what, well done for doing that. I hope other sisters can come out and say what you said. We need sisters like you. So far, I haven't got anything negative. Like, go and ask a fighting Muslim who's probably not spoken out at all. And this is men and women I'm talking about now, not just women, who are frightened, who won't say a word, who are quiet. Those numbers are way more than the numbers are in the books. No matter how strong, I can promise you one thing, being Muslim, easily that scary feeling can come back just like this. And I cannot confidently sit here and say that, oh, wow, I can face anything. No, I can't. But knock me down and I promise you I'll stand up again.